Yo, what's up? So guys, it is 6:30 on a Monday morning. Now what you saw there was, I have my timer that wakes me up at 6:30 nonetheless, but then shortly after that I have Bob, who's my business mentor. He calls me. Now that kills two birds with one stone. Number one, make sure my ass is out of bed, and when it's not, well, I pay the price. Like yesterday I sent him £20, which is basically like my accountability and my way to make sure that there are actually consequences. So number one, I make sure my ass is out of bed. Number two, when I wake up, I go through a list of things that I'm working on the business today. So kills two birds with one stone. I'm still unsure as to what to call this new series. Maybe it'll have no title, but I've been lacking on YouTube recently, and that's because all the focus has been on the business now. But I do want to get back into it now. That involves building systems. Now for the next 2 weeks I will do this vlog style, but then after that I'll probably get someone on board to film in third person. The whole point of this is to show you what the lifestyle of a young entrepreneur looks like. I see a lot of interesting videos out there where, you know, people are entrepreneurs and they're waking up at like 9 and then they're going to like breakfast meetings and then they're doing all this cool shit. And I mean, all of that is cool. Trust me, that's the highlights. I do crazy shit in my spare time, but most of my days involve waking up at 6:30, meditating, reading, and getting to work. So I wake up, I make myself a coffee, I read for 20 minutes, sit over there, meditate. Now this morning, I actually am not getting to work first thing, because I actually have a tennis class. Tennis is a sport that I've always really wanted to get into, but I've never been able to afford tennis classes for myself. So now that things are a bit better, I'm actually taking one-to-one private lessons for as long as I want, really. So that's the plan for this morning.
So, all done with tennis. It is like 9 o'clock right now, so time to get back and start on my work blocks. Tennis was super fun. It was my first tennis lesson ever, actually. It's always something I wanted to do, as I said.
So, I'm showered up, cleaned up, about to sit down for work block one. Now, I don't work in time, in hours. I work in blocks. Now, blocks are 60 minutes. Sometimes they're 90 minutes, but usually I keep them 60 minutes. Now, right now it's 10 o'clock, so I'm gonna do a work block one, 15 minute break, work block two, lunch, and then three work blocks with 50 minute rest in between. And that's pretty much how my day goes. I think in blocks rather than time. So let's get into it.
Now what you've told the guy before this point specifically apply. Remember I said yesterday?
So guys, very productive morning. Got through two 60 minute work blocks. Now I'm actually on my lunch break right now. What you will see behind me is Jerome Belford's Straight Line Persuasion, which gets me thinking. I get so many questions from people as to like, how do I build my brand culture and how do I stand out and how do I refine my service or my product to the best of its ability? Dude, fuck all that. Like honestly, I don't know in a B2C environment, but B2B, unless you're doing $5,000 a month in profit, just don't even think about the quality of your service. And as terrible as that sounds, getting sales through the door, that gives you the space and the time to actually think about the service, refine the service, spend money on courses, training. But until you're at that stage, you need to have a monastic obsession with selling. If you're not spending 90% of your time selling or networking, you're seriously fucking up. So for any of you guys saying that your marketing agency or your creative agency isn't unique or it doesn't stand out, shove all that shit in the toilet until you're making some real money.
Channels. I'm looking at smaller ones just to give you a, okay? He does iPhone 6 in 2017.
So guys, it is 4:30 right now and I'm done with my work day. 6:30 to 4:30. I'm sure it must have come off as very boring and tedious and menial, and that's exactly what it is. So around 4 o'clock, I try to finish up my work, and then four until the rest of the day is left for seeing friends. Sometimes I have meetings. Any new projects that take up a lot of time, I'll do then. Usually, as I said, I don't do my exercise in the morning. I do it in the afternoon. But now I'm off to go see some friends that I haven't seen in a while. And then after that, I have a coffee with my graphic designer just to catch up. So let's go.
Have you ever been on this before?
Yeah, I've been on it like 3 times or 4 times.
Oh yeah, Vicky's room.
And more. When we did that photo shoot of me, do you remember?
Next up, quick coffee with my graphic designer.
Right, I'm Sol, and I'm a graphic designer for IAG Media, and as a freelancer myself. And I'm planning to open a company mid-August.
Yeah. There you go. Can you show the secret plan?
Yeah.
Not too much.
There you go.
Wait, tell them how old you are.
I've just turned 16 actually.
Crazy.
So guys, there we have it. My first vlog in probably a few months. Now I do want to leave you with one thing. I actually just finished up with an Instagram edit and I'm going to cue that now.
Mouth and a slick ass flow. Got your bitch around me, nigga. Ain't a plan when I'm coming for the kitty. Got my full goddamn. Do it for my niggas in the coast right there. Do it for my niggas in the ghost right now. Niggas got killed for the boy. Living dreams in the hills and they watching for the boy right now. Goddamn, what a time, what a year.
So, I hope you enjoyed that. That was actually a recap of the past 45 days. Now, the reason I showed you is compare that to what you just saw from my day. Do you now see how all of that is the byproduct of hours and hours of work? It still baffles me how all these fucking entrepreneurs are going on all these coffee meetings from breakfast to morning and renting out these cool sports cars and doing all this shit, but I never actually see them work. Or if they are working, it would be really, really cool if they showed more of their audience that, because there is this big, big misconception that you can just snap your fingers, you can manifest all your dreams and your desires. It's not like that. You have to work for it. You have to put deep, focused work in. You have to discipline yourself. You have to resist a lot of temptation and a lot of distraction. And then when it is time to have fun, you can have experience that'll genuinely blow your fucking mind. So I hope you see the correlation there. Anyways, if you guys enjoyed this, please leave a like. Next week, I'll also be vlogging, except I'll be in Paris. I'm actually taking my mom to Paris. She's never been. I've always promised her, and I like to make good on my promises. So I will see you then. There's also a video this Sunday, a really cool one all about books right over there. So I'll see you guys then.